Stuff on the internet. Now, if you've watched every single video I've done on the topic, then you'll know that there is this other medium shank that is 11.9 and 124. Here's an adapter for it. I had it made. Now, I've speculated that a lot of these kind of cheap Asian, you know, Indian and Chinese made instruments, particularly like the older designs, they have this kind of weird medium shank that isn't, is actually this. And indeed, I checked this horn, and this is not actually a step bore taper. It does have a taper in here. Now it's out of round because this brass is terrible. It's very thin. But if I shove this guy in here and give it the old twist, it does eventually catch and not wobble over the place. That's very nice. So that would seem to confirm my suspicions. Now, this does not work on the Maestro anymore, although it might have been the original shank type for the Maestro. I've, however, reamed that twice successfully, and so now this doesn't fit in it anymore. And I'm going to show you, actually, it's very difficult to deduce if a mouthpiece has this taper on this shank. Because if you stick this in even best in medium shank, it barely wobbles. The other way around, though, you get lots of wobbles, so. Pretty weird that. So anyway, you stick this on a mouthpiece, it makes it pretty long, which is correct. I mean, I've never seen a mouthpiece with this taper on it. It'd be next to impossible to figure out if I had one, but my speculation is that based on Remington shank mouthpieces, 11.9 and 1-24 would also be a very long mouthpiece. Oh, yes, I am going to indeed torture you with this horn. I'm not going to tell you it's perfect. I haven't fixed it. But, it has improved a little bit. The Yosef Clear 1B with a 7.6 millimeter throat. So, well, it's pretty appropriate for something like this. This absolutely oversized baritone, basically. Works pretty well in here. Let's do some shenanigans. Let me show you what this thing can really do. Well, what it's kind of capable of doing. I mean, I ain't gonna show you what anything can really do, because I'm not that good. There, but hey, you could tell what it was. Now look you there. Once again, you do not need a fourth valve. All you need is that false pedal tone and a brain good enough to switch between regular and false tone fingerings, which is It can be kind of tricky, but if I can almost do it, I'm sure like anyone else can actually do it. Yeah, okay, there, you can drop octave. Drop octave on a 9-foot B-flat instrument. It really is a sousaphone. Help if I could be smart enough. There we go. I say there we go, it still is terrible, but a B flat to an F for the treble clef minded. I mean, we're hitting fourth valve territory just on the fly. Brilliant. Okay. Let's, well, first off, let's shove this into something where it seems like it might belong, but I assure you it doesn't. Uh-oh. Did I get one wrong? Yes and no. Diddly. That goes right in there, doesn't it? Yeah. Now, of course, I don't actually know if this is correct in terms of taper. It could have been reamed. This thing sure is thin. However, what I can tell you from playtesting it is that it's not this. Okay. An 11.5 millimeter shank or adapter wobbling around in here is way better than this to play on. So, don't panic. It's fine. Stick with the wobbly 11.5. It might not even wobble for your instrument, because, again, I don't know. Maybe Igor took this one out and reamed her out with something. I don't know. I mean, this is not exactly the most trustworthy-looking receiver. Just a tube with a decoration on the end, basically, you know. Hey, 1-24, it is catching. It ain't 1-24 with an 11.9 millimeter shank. Yeah. I assure you that. Stick with the 11.5. Now, next, we gotta show you what happens when we stick this in something that don't fit in at all, right? Now, here's where things get tricky. We have best in medium shank. It's not even 1-20, it's wider than that. We stick a 1-24 taper adapter into this guy. Boy, that seems like that just went right in there. Now, it does wobble, though. There is wobble here. It's not in properly. I don't know what it's catching on. I assume, let's see, it's 1-24, so it's straighter, so it's hitting at the bottom. But boy, you can barely tell. I mean, compared to, well, a lot of other things that people just roll with, this would be perfectly normal. But it's not right. We shouldn't get that kind of intonation problem with this mouthpiece. That's for dang sure. That's interesting. You get kind of the same problem on the Russian tenor horn. It also gets intonation issues with this. So again, yeah, best of luck trying to sort out. I don't know what you'd do if you actually had a mouthpiece with this. How you'd ever know? It wobbles a little bit, shove it harder, right? It's not like the Remington shank where it's so big that how do you not notice? It's not like that at all. Again, look at, you know, we're making this mouthpiece quite a bit longer. Keep that in mind. So I guess if you got a weird kind of really long medium shank mouthpiece. That might be 1 to 24. I don't know, at this point I'm just kind of rambling. If you got one of those like weird Chinese baritones with some kind of weird medium shank that seems to just wobble on everything, it's probably this. I'm thinking about getting one of those Indian baritones that's definitely not a euphonium, but they put them on as euphoniums. Thinking about getting one to see if it's this. I don't know if it's worth the money, though. Don't know. But, hey, a little more documentation. Never hurt anybody.